Hi, this is Paul Ross. I'm product manager for ArcGIS Online. In this video, I'm going to be introducing you to the new item pages. These are part of the June 2016 update to ArcGIS Online. Before we see the new look, how about a little background on items? Items are all of your ArcGIS Online content and everything cataloged on ArcGIS Online. This includes maps, apps, layers, services, links to services or files you've stored on your account. So examples would be things like web maps, apps, feature services, or maybe CSV files that you've uploaded. Now, each item in ArcGIS has a page with detailed descriptive information and options to use or configure that item. So for example, you could open it, you could add to favorites, share through social media, add ratings and comments, see the number of views and downloads. To access item details for each item, you click Details under any item's thumbnail or from the gallery, hover over the thumbnail and click Details. Now, if you own the item, you can access details in your contents. On the screen, you'll see an example item page for items before the June 2016 update. This one happens to be for a feature service. You can see action items at the top to do something with it, followed by the description. Things like access and use constraints, the layers contained in the items, and any other properties and settings. Each item type follows the same basic format, but differs in the options and what actions are based on if you own the item, or if you're using it, or of course the item type. A web map, for example, has different properties than a simple file stored in ArcGIS. So why are we changing the item page? Well, it's about improving workflows, everyone's workflows, from people who are exploring items, searching and finding them, to users who are publishing items. It's also about providing some new functionality alongside of everything that you could do before. So as you take a look at the new design, you're going to see we've updated the visual look and feel of item details, changing the type, the colors, and layout to make it easier and more efficient to get your work done. For example, we'll highlight the most common actions in the top right of the page, using new button styles to make it easy to open a layer in the map viewer, create a presentation, or share the item. New button styles and typography will guide you to the workflows and content that matter the most. The new tab layout gives us a little bit more room to add new features while still keeping the look streamlined and easy to use. Now, for users exploring an item, they'll get more information and see the most important information first. So all the important elements are front and center in the overview tab. For data publishers, we've consolidated a lot of the actions like changing the layer defaults or editing the item's descriptions right in place. There are also some new workflows for publishers like editing the data in a table. So let's take a look at the new item page and how it's going to look after the June update with a quick demo. So I've logged into my ArcGIS Online account and I've gone to my contents and clicked on one of my items. This one happens to be a feature service. Note that depending on the item, you're going to see different information that's appropriate for that item. Also note that I'm the owner of this particular item, and I have the ability to change the settings. At the end, I'll show you what the item looks like to someone who's using the item and not the owner. Now, while we've improved the design, everything you could do before is not only available on the item page, but also in the familiar places you accessed them before. You'll also see we've added some new features to help you in your work. The overall design uses this new tabbed layout. Makes things easy to find, add, edit information about an item, and you're going to see more in-depth information provided for each item, with the most important information presented first. So let's walk through some of the most important parts of each of the tabs, starting with the overview. And the first thing you're going to notice is the in-place editing that's available for item descriptions and other information. So I can go right into the edit. And change things if I'd like. Save it. and I can do the same thing for description or some of the other areas. Now you'll also notice the buttons on the right hand side for some of the most important or common things that you're going to want to do with an item. You can open it in the map viewer, open it in the scene viewer, publish it perhaps to a tile service. You can export the data to different formats, and you can take on the sharing options and change those. Let's scroll down a little bit to see what else is on the overview page. You'll see the details, who owns it, what folder I have it in, tags, and of course, I can edit those tags as I go along and save those without having to get into an edit mode. You can see the layers. I can change those. Again, I can open things, export it. I can change the time setting, enable attachments, and look at the service URL if I want. Now, one of the things you're going to notice that's really different here are comments. And you can see that someone has left a comment on this, and I can sort those, but I can also take a look at all the other comments that are made, and I might want to reply to Kelly's comment. So now you can see all the comments. If I want to delete them, I can also do that. Now what's really cool about this is that when someone leaves a comment, the owner of the item will get an email telling them that there's a new comment, and if I reply to someone's comment, they will also get an email. So now let's check out the data tab. This is something pretty new. Here you can view the data in a table format. If you have editing privileges on the layer, you can make changes to the data. So I would simply want to double click, make my edit, and I can save it. The table also integrates related records and attachment and allows you to sort the rows and see summary statistics on the numeric fields. Now let's switch to the visualization tab. In the visualization tab, you can save a lot of time with visualizing and editing directly from the item. There's no longer this need to switch back and forth between the item and the map viewer. So here you can configure feature layer styles. I can change my style. I can configure my pop-ups and other common actions on the layer. The usage tab allows me to select the time period and look and see how often my item is being used. I can look in the past 24 hours, over the past 14 days, a custom date range. I can set it from the beginning of May, update the report, and take a look. On the settings tab, I can configure things like delete protection. I can set the extent of my layer. I can enable editing on it. Who can edit those layers? I can allow or disallow exporting of the data, and then enable or disable sync and save those changes. Now, I had mentioned that it looks different to a user. So let's take a look at how this service would look to a user. So this is someone who doesn't own it, and you can see the information is a little bit different. So I can open it in the map viewer or the scene viewer like the other. I don't have the editing options. I do, if I'm logged in, I can comment. I can see the data, but I don't have that same capability to edit it because I'm not an editor. And I can visualize the layer without going over to the map viewer. So just in summary, the item overview got me to the layers, the descriptions, the access and use constraints. I could make the comments and remember those email back and forth about the comments and the replies to those. I can open it, publish it, export it. I can do the sharing there. And then there's all the details. In the data tab, I can view and edit, sort, select rows, show and hide columns, and I can get summary information or summary statistics about a column. In the visualization, I could change the layer's default styles, change the filters, the pop-ups, the labeling, And I could also save the layer, or more importantly, I can save as. I can save it as a new layer. Usage showed me how it's being used over a period of time. And settings allowed me to get at delete protection, setting the extent, the editing options, and whether it can be exported, enabled sync or not, track editing options, change the owner. So that was an overview of the new item pages on ArcGIS Online that will be updated in our June update. Here's some information about more information, how you can provide us with feedback, or if you have ideas. So for more information, the online help after the update will detail everything that I've shown you. We're also planning some blog posts. You can always send us your feedback at arcgisonline_feedback@esri.com. Or if you have ideas for other product improvements or new functionality, let us know at the ideas site at ideas.arcgis.com. Thanks for watching. We hope these new item pages make working with ArcGIS easier, and that the new functionality gives you some new tools to be even more productive.